Hey everyone, and welcome back to Shadyside Library. My name is Zach, and today we got a Goosebumps video. And honestly, I looked down at what I was wearing today, and I was like, I literally wear a Goosebumps shirt probably every other day. And the day I decide to film a Goosebumps video, I'm like decked out in Cowboys gear. Like my jacket, my necklace, my shirt. I mean, I am ready for football season, but this is a booktube channel, not a football tube. Is that a thing? Anyways, I had a thought just right before filming this video. I think I might try to start filming videos in front of other bookshelves. I'll be honest with you guys, I have tons of other bookshelves. I do owe you guys a tour of this one, that's for sure. But I have other bookshelves, and they're not in my room, and I don't really have a place to sit in front of them, but maybe I'll stand. I don't know. I just think it'd be cool to, you know, have different scenery and, you know, give you guys a bit of a different experience, because my videos aren't, like, repetitive, but I mean, I do sit in the same place and talk about, I talk about different things, but I do just sit in the same place every time, so. Anyways, story time over. Let's look at some hardcover Goosebumps books, because I found a local listing for 17 hardcover Goosebumps books. And it was an hour away, and I was like, I can't make that drive, and I have surgery coming up, and I asked if the lady could ship them, and she was like, sure. And so she shipped them, and I swear to you, this has never happened to me. I always have great luck with the post office. Well, I was so excited about this package that I turned on, like, text notifications about when it would come in, and it bounced around Texas a little bit, and I was like, okay, it's on its way, it's getting closer. I mean, she's only an hour away. And then I got a notification that said it was gonna arrive on the day of surgery, and I was like, oh sweet, like, you know, it's coming. And then it said it got delayed, and I was like, nah, that's okay, it'll come tomorrow. Then I got a notification that said it's in North Carolina. And I was like, wait. I live in Texas. This lady lives an hour away from me in Texas. And you're telling me that the books are in North Carolina? Moral of the story, the books eventually came, but the box was beat to crap. I mean, it was completely, like, torn open. I mean, you could see the books, but I don't care. These books are from a library. They're battered, but they're hardcover Goosebumps books. All right, enough. It's 4 minutes in, and I haven't even shown you a book. All right, so these are all from the Central Florida Regional Library, and they're kind of like custom hardcovers. I don't know how to explain it. But they've definitely been read before. So, I've read a lot of these, but I am excited to read the ones I haven't read in hardcover form. Because, I mean, if I'm going to read the book, like, I think it'd be fun to read the hardcover. I don't know, I love hardcovers, and these are cool, and, you know, it's the same story. So, yeah. All right, so we've got The Abominable Snowman of Pasadena. Wait. Alright, I actually have not read that one yet. And then we've got, ooh, The Barking Ghost. Heard it's horrible, but, you know, still gotta read it. And all these hardcovers are absolutely identical. I mean, they all look the exact same. The spines line up, and the spines say the name of the book, which is kind of cool. It's interesting, but then the front I don't know. But the spines all look good in unison, so it's pretty cool. I don't know. Revenge of the Lawn Gnomes. You guys are probably gonna be disappointed in me, but I haven't read that one either. Ooh, Night of the Living Dummy. I have definitely read this one, and I am happy to have it in hardcover. Next up, we've got Monster Blood 2 with Cuddles. And I have read this one, and you can tell that, like, the better covers and the better books are more battered. Like, there's a couple of these. Maybe, like, The Barking Ghost was one of them. But they're, like, a lot cleaner because the kids didn't gravitate towards them. It's pretty funny. Here's The Cuckoo Clock of Doom. I've read that one. I wanted to know what it was all about. Oh, here's a classic, The Horror at Camp Jelly Jam. This is a great, probably the best Goosebumps camp book. I gotta say it. And I think a lot of people agree with me. Welcome to Camp Nightmare. Overrated. Sorry about y'all. Okay, next up is going to be It Came from Beneath the Sink. One I've heard is incredible that I have not read. I'll be honest, I haven't read much Goosebumps lately just because there's so many series out there. I want to read everything. So yeah, I don't know. Maybe I just need to binge read a bunch of them. Set aside like a week or a month and just go Goosebumps crazy. I don't know. Piano Lessons Can Be Murder. This is a fun one. Incredible cover. And I'm so happy to have these in hardcover. It's just, oh, it's awesome. I don't know where I'm gonna put them yet. Spines don't really look that good. They're all plain. So maybe I'll find a way to display them like this. I don't know. Attack of the Mutant. I haven't read this, and honestly, I'm an on and off superhero fan. Like, sometimes I get really into Marvel and then I lose interest, but I don't know. I feel like I might enjoy this one next time I'm feeling superhero-ish. All right, Monster Blood, a classic. I've read all the Monster Blood books, and unfortunately, no, I don't have Monster Blood 4 in hardcover. So you can click off the video if you're waiting to see if I had that one. I don't. I'm sorry. All right, My Hairiest Adventure. This is like the cleanest one. You can tell nobody wanted to read this book. And I guess that's true for me as well because I haven't read this one. I have enough hair already. I'm good. I don't need to read about some kid growing more hair. Even though I'm reading a werewolf novel right now, I don't know. I should be more transparent with you guys about what I'm reading, but I'm just plowing through books. I mean, plowing with this whole surgery recovery thing. I can't stop reading books. I mean, and I'll be honest with you guys, I've been writing. I've been grinding out some writing, and it feels good. My creative juices are flowing, and fingers crossed, I'm gonna have a book for you guys to read one day. And that makes me emotional. So we're gonna keep going and talk about The Werewolf Fever Swamp. A favorite amongst a lot of people, but not myself. Don't hate me. I don't know. I wasn't a huge fan of that one. I went into it with too high of expectations. Return of the Mummy. But Werewolf Fever Swamp, that cover is incredible, so I'll give that one to Tim Jacobus. Stay Out of the Basement, book two. And I'm sorry I gotta break it to you guys. I didn't get a Welcome to Dead House either, and I hate that because that's my favorite Goosebumps book, and I would have liked to have it in hardcover, but that's okay. I got Say Cheese and Die, though. And that's classic. You can tell this one was pretty well read, and that's because that cover is incredible. If I saw that as a kid, I would be very scared and not pick up the book. But if I saw that as a 25-year-old, I would pick it up and read it. And that's what I did. I'm just full of jokes today. All right, last one. This is number 17. Wow, great way to end the video. I hope you guys stayed for this long because I got One Day at Horrorland in hardcover. Just had to prove it to you guys. But, yeah, I'm really happy with this haul. I have never seen so many hardcovers for sale at once, except like on eBay. And usually those listings go for a lot. And usually they're auctions and people bid over $100. And I don't know, I got really lucky. And I am happy to have a bunch of hardcover Goosebumps books. Even though they're ex-library, that just makes them more unique, honestly. It's really cool. And to be quite honest, if I ever get the chance to meet Tim Jacobus, I would probably take this book right here and have him sign it. Because this cover is absolutely iconic. And might as well have him sign the hardcover version I have, right? Oh, and I would have him sign the Art of Goosebumps book. Yeah, I'd have a handful of books if I had met that man. Just like I did when I met R.L. Stein. That concludes my haul. I have some other hauls for you guys. I have a Fear Street haul that I really want to share with you guys. But we had to talk Goosebumps today. I hope you enjoyed. Do y'all have any hardcover Goosebumps books? And who wants to buddy read some Goosebumps? Because I need to read a lot of these classics. I still can't say I've read the original 62 because I haven't. And I've been collecting these. Well, I've owned the original 62 for over a year. So it's about time I read them. So there's just so much good stuff out there. All right, that's all. Thanks for watching, guys. And I guess, go Cowboys? Peace out. And Glendy, don't you dare say go Packers in the comments. Peace out, guys.